you didn't kill our mom because...
Miss Kane, restrain yourself or I will hold you in contempt.
Please, Your Honor, please. My daughter doesn't know what she's saying. Please, I would like to have a recess.
No, no, it's okay. I have to do this now.
Return to your seat now.
Bianca. Tell us what you remembered.
I was in the room. And Frankie was lying face down on the floor. And I was kneeling beside her and I turned her over.
Go on.
There was a butterfly design on her shirt, and there was blood, and she was so pale. I tried to revive her.
Take your time, Bianca.
I reached for her wrist so that I could take a pulse, and she was clutching something in her hand.
What was in her hand?
It was the locket that I gave her.
You saw the locket the police found at your mother's house. Was it, in fact, the same one?
Yes, it was. Frankie still had the locket. My mother had not been there yet, and she was already dead. You didn't kill her, Mom. You didn't kill Frankie.
Bianca, sweetheart, no, no, you're confused, honey. Because of your concussion, because of your fall, you're not remembering correctly.
Miss Kane, this is my final warning to
you. No, please, Your Honor, please let me help my daughter.
Miss Montgomery, are you in any need of assistance?
No, Your Honor, it's all coming back to me, all of it.
Please, let my daughter at least have a glass of water. Please, let her, she needs time. She needs a little time to pull herself together.
Pinky back on the stand. The jury was ready to hang her.
She's got her memory back. Enough to clear Erica of murder.
No, this is not happening.
I don't get it, Mom. Why would you say that you killed her when you didn't?
Bianca, what's done is done. Just let it go.
I can't let it go, Mom. For Frankie's sake, I can't.
Your Honor, if you would.
I think now would be a good time to advise Miss Montgomery of her right to an attorney.
Miss Montgomery, it would be advisable that you consult with a lawyer before continuing.
Why do I need a lawyer?
You may say something on this witness stand to incriminate yourself.
Truth can't hurt me, Mom, can it? Can it? Oh my God! You lied because I did it! You lied to protect me because I killed her! I killed Frankie!
This is nothing but a big act to say that Erica's lying behind.
Miss Hart, you are out of order.
Hey, why don't you sit down and shut up?
No, Bianca is lying. Can't you see that? Erica's guilty. She confessed. This is just another stunt she cooked up to avoid doing hard time.
Miss Hart, I'm not going to tell you again.
Playing her daughter as a get-out-of-jail card.
No, you're the one she played, Kendall.
No way.
Yeah, look at it. You're the last person on Earth that my mother would call in for help, but she did. She did it because she knew that she could count on you to make her look even more guilty.
You are such a liar. Erica called me because she...
Because she was desperate to protect me.
Because she needed me. Tell her, Erica. Tell her about the phone call in the middle of the night. You told me I was the only one you could turn to. Bianca couldn't do anything. Only I could help you. Tell her.
I request that Miss Hart be removed from the courtroom.
Please, she's got as much right to be here as you do. With your rap sheet, what do you get off?
You know, remove Miss Hart and her disruptive friend. Right now, remove from the courtroom.
Bianca, you said that everything your mother has done since she found Frankie dead was to... protect you.
Yes, it had to be. She did everything that she could to make herself look guilty, to keep me safe. She focused the investigation on herself and away from me. That's why she called Kendall, because she knew that she could count on her to make trouble.
To divert suspicion from you? To keep you from being implicated in Frankie's murder?
It makes sense in a warped kind of way. I can't picture it. I don't understand how I could do that. I loved Frankie.
Bianca, you said earlier, you stated that you went back to the house to tell Frankie that you hated her.
I did hate her that day.
Enough to kill her?
Oh, stop it, please, Chris. Please, hasn't my daughter suffered enough? Do you have to go on torturing her?
Miss Kane, you are on my last nerve.
It's okay, Mom. I want to remember. I have to remember. I was furious with Frankie for betraying me. So I went back to the house. And the front door was open. And I walked up the steps, ready to have it out with her. But I got to the door and I opened it up and I saw her lying on the ground, and she wasn't moving, and I tried to wake her, and she still wasn't moving, and there was all this blood, and oh my god, she was dead when I got there. Kill Frankie. It wasn't me.
Aren't you going to object?
No, there's no reason to.
Bianca, you're absolutely sure about what you saw.
I'm sure. I walked into the room and she was lying dead on the floor. My heart stopped. Even though she had betrayed me, I loved her and she was dead. It almost killed me, too.
So then what did you do?
I just ran. I couldn't stand seeing her like that. I couldn't take it anymore. I ran out and I got into my car and I just drove away. Frankie had always told me, don't ever look back. So I didn't. I just ran.
Your witness. I have no questions. The defense rests, Your Honor.
Mr. Montgomery, do either of you gentlemen wish to amend your closing statements?
No, Your Honor, the Commonwealth does not.
The last witness speaks for me, Your Honor.
Very well. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, once again, you are given this case for your deliberation. And once again, you are charged with determining whether or not Miss Erica Kane is guilty or not guilty in the murder of Mary Frances Stone. Now, I realize that today's proceedings have been a little, let's say, unorthodox. And I do realize that the last witness that you heard will be the freshest in your mind when you begin deliberations. But I caution you to accord all testimony you've heard in this trial the same consideration. Review all of the evidence carefully. And I want you to determine your final verdict based on the merits of this case in its entirety. So, charge, this court is adjourned until the jury returns with its verdict.